So let's keep thinking about different ways to sit multiple people in a certain number of chairs. So let's say we have six people. We have person A, we have person B, we have person C, person D, person E, and we have person F. So we have six people. And for the sake of this video, we're going to say, oh, we want to figure out all the scenarios, all the possibilities, all the permutations, all the ways that we could put them into three chairs. So that's chair number one, chair number two, and chair number three. This is all a review. This is covered in the permutations video, but it'll be very instructive as we move into a new concept. So what are all of the permutations of putting six different people into three chairs? Well, like we've seen before, we could start with the first chair, and we could say, look, if no one sat, if we haven't seated anyone yet, how many different people could we put in chair number one? Well, there's six different people who could be in chair number one. Let me do that in a different color. There are six people who could be in chair number one. Six different scenarios for who sits in chair number one. Now, for each of those six scenarios, how many different people could sit in chair number two? Well, in each of those six scenarios, we've taken one of the six people to sit in chair number one, so that means you have five out of the six people left to sit in chair number two. Or another way to think about it is there's six scenarios of someone in chair number one, and for each of those six, you have five scenarios for who's in chair number two. So you have a total of 30 scenarios where you have seated six people in the first two chairs. And now, if you want to say, well, what about for the three chairs? Well, for each of these 30 scenarios, how many different people could you put in chair number three? Well, you're still going to have four people standing up, not in chairs. So for each of these 30 scenarios, you have four people who you could put in chair number three. So your total number of scenarios, or your total number of permutations, where we care who's sitting in which chair, is 6 times 5 times 4, which is equal to 120 permutations. Permutations. Now, let me just, permutations. Now, it's worth thinking about what permutations are counting. Now, remember, we care, when we're talking about permutations, we care about who's sitting in which chair. So, for example, this is one permutation, and this would be counted as another permutation. And this would be counted as one, as another permutation. This would be counted as another permutation. So notice, these are all with the same three people, but we're putting them in different chairs. And this counted that. That's counted in this 120. I could keep going. We could have that, or we could have that. So when we're thinking in the permutation world, we would count all of these, or we would count this as six different permutations. These are going towards this 120. And of course, we have other permutations where we involve other people, where we have, it could be F, B, C, F, C, B, F, A, C, F, F. Actually, let me do it this way. I'm going to be a little bit more systematic. F, let me do it. B, B, F, C, B, C, F. And obviously, I could keep going. I do 120 of these. I'll do two more. You could have C, F, B, and then you could have C, B, F. So in the permutation world, these are literally 12 of the 120 permutations. But what if all we cared about is the three people we're choosing to sit down, but we don't care in what order that they're sitting or in which chair they're sitting? So in that world, these would all be one. This is all the same set of three people if we don't care which chair they're sitting in. This would also be the same set of three people. And so this question, if I have six people sitting in three chairs, how many ways can I choose three people out of the six where I don't care which chair they sit on? And I encourage you to pause the video and try to think of what that number would actually be. Well, a big clue was when we essentially wrote all of the permutations where we've picked a group of three people. We see that there's six ways of arranging the three people. When you pick a certain group of three people, that turned into six permutations. And so if all you want to do is care about, well, how many different ways are there to choose three from the six, you would take your number of permutations, and then you would divide it by the number of ways to arrange three people. Number of ways to arrange three people. And we see that you can arrange three people, or even three letters, you can arrange it in six different ways. So this would be equal to 120 divided by 6, or this would be equal to 20. So there were 120 permutations here. If you said, how many different arrangements are there of taking 6 people and putting them into 3 chairs, that's 120. But now we're asking another thing. We're saying, if we start with 120 people, and we want to choose, and we want to, if we're starting with 6 people, and we want to figure out how many ways, how many combinations, how many ways are there for us to choose 3 of them, then we end up with 20 combinations of people. This right over here, once again, this right over here is just one combination. It's the combination A, B, C. I don't care what order they sit in. I've chosen them. I've chosen these 3 of the 6. This is a combination of people. I don't care about the order. This right over here is another combination. It is F, C, and B. Once again, I don't care about the order. I just care that I've chosen these 3 people. So how many ways are there to choose 3 people out of 6? It is 20. It's the total number of permutations. It's 120 divided by the number of ways you can arrange 3 people.